Hello student, welcome to digital classes. This video is for class 8. The subject is science. This is the continue of the chapter number 12, friction, means this is the second part for this chapter number 12. In the previous video I explained about the force of friction, causes of friction due to the interlocking of surface, due to the force of adhesion between the two surface, factor on which the force of friction depends. Friction is a self-adjusting force. In this video I am going to tell you about the kind of friction, that is static, sliding and rolling. Why is friction considered a necessary evil, means the advantage of friction, disadvantage of friction. And I will discuss also about the rolling friction is much smaller than the sliding friction as well as static friction. Now, what is force of friction? Force of friction is the force when opposes the motion of an object over a surface. The force of friction acts between the object and the surface. For example, a ball rolling on the ground gradually slows down and comes to rest due to the force of friction between the ball and the ground. Basically, friction is caused due to the interlocking of surface. No solid surface is perfectly smooth. This means all solid surfaces are rough. The degree of roughness varies from the surface to surface. Some are more rough while some other are less. Even a surface which look smooth to the naked eye is actually rough. In case if we using a magnifying glasses to watch the surface, a smooth surface according to our eyes, we feel there is a irregular surface that is seen with the help of lens. When a body is pulled over another, these hills and valley, basically the roughness is termed as hills and valley, interlock each other and opposes the relative motion between the two bodies. This gives rise to the frictional force. Thus the friction is due to the roughness of two surfaces in the contact. Now the kind of friction, there are three kind of friction. These are static friction, sliding friction and rolling friction. First, static friction. Friction is a self-adjusting force. Thus, when the applied force is gradually increased, the force of the friction also increases at the same rate and the body remains stationary. This force of friction is called force of static friction or simply static friction. If the applied force is increased further, a stage reaches when the body begins to just move. At this stage, the force of static friction is maximum, means force is maximum. The maximum force of friction when block is just starting to move is called the limiting value of the static friction or limiting friction. In other words, static friction, when a body is at rest, the force of friction is called the static friction and is equal, always equal and opposite to the applied force. It means when the external force is applied to move an object, but the object remain at rest. Because the exerted force, the external force is equal to the static friction. So the object remain at rest. The force of friction which act when the body is just at the verge of sliding on the surface is called a limiting friction. Limiting means that when we apply external force, it limit our force, that is equal to the static friction, means the object is not able to move from its initial position. Now sliding friction, the friction from which opposes the actual relative sliding motion between two contact surface. Sliding friction is smaller than static friction. The force of friction between the two object in contact when one of them just slides over the other is called sliding or kinetic friction. द फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू कीप अ बॉडी इन मोशन इज लेस देन द फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू स्टार्ट द मोशन, देयरफॉर स्लाइडिंग और अ काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन इज लेस देन द लिमिटिंग स्टैटिक फ्रिक्शन. इन स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन व्हेन वी अप्लाई अ एक्सटर्नल फोर्स टू मूव एन ऑब्जेक्ट, द ऑब्जेक्ट विल मूव बिकॉज द एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज ग्रेटर देन द स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन और अ काइनेटिक फ्रिक्शन. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज रोलिंग फ्रिक्शन. द फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन एग्जिस्टिंग बिटवीन द टू सर्फेस इन कॉन्टेक्ट वेन वन ऑफ देम इज रोलिंग ओवर द अदर इज कॉल्ड रोलिंग फ्रिक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ द मोशन ऑफ द बॉल रोलिंग ऑन ए फ्लोर इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रोलिंग फ्रिक्शन. Wheel makes the movement of the luggage easy because they reduce friction and there is a rolling friction. Rolling friction is much smaller than the sliding friction. That is why all the vehicles are mounted on wheels and ball bearings are used in all machines where rotatory motion is required. In a ball bearing, the axle rotates on the ball without sliding. Rolling provide less friction as compared to sliding. Rolling friction is less than sliding friction. Machine use ball bearing to reduce the friction of the moving parts. Now you can see the rolling friction. Push the wheel. Wheel rolls forward. Friction resisting rolling. So the basically the area of contact between the wheel and the surface is less, so less friction is applicable during or on rolling friction. Now the causes of friction. Friction occur due to the surface irregularity of the two object in contact, adhesive force between the surface and contact, Poving effect. I already told about this in the previous video. If there is a confusion, you can go through the video number 1. Now the surface irregularity. All surface well zoomed in a microscopic level contain hills and valley that interlock when they move or rubbed on the surface of each other. This unevenness of the surface is called as surface irregularity or roughness. Rough surface have large irregularities while smooth surface have lesser irregularity. So there is a friction between the rough surfaces more as compared to the smooth surface. One more time I explain about the adhesive forces. When two surfaces are in contact, they start to form bond and begin to stick to each other. This phenomena is called as adhesion. When we try to move object that are on top of the another, we are basically breaking the bond of the overcoming the adhesive forces. Now the calculating frictional force using a spring balance. Using a spring balance, we can find the frictional force opposed by different material. Sandpapers give a highly reading as compared to the stainless steel, means the sandpaper is rough and the stainless steel is smooth. Now you can see in this picture there is a friction, and when we use spring balance to measure the friction, in this the 5 newton of friction is applied on the surface. Now the sliding friction or the kinetic friction. The friction that comes into play when the object are in motion is called a kinetic friction. Now let us perform an activity to understand about the friction. A rolling friction is smaller or greater than the sliding friction. To show that rolling friction is smaller than the sliding friction, this is the activity number 2 and given in your book, page number 194. Material required: a thick book, cylindrical pencil 3-4. Procedure: follow the step given below. Place the book on the table and push it to the slide. Feel how much force is required to push it. Place three or four cylindrical pencil on the table parallel to each other. These pencils are acting as a roller. Now place a book over these pencil that is shown in the figure and push the book by ticking it. The book moves easily. Result, the book moves easily when placed on cylindrical pencils or rollers. Conclusion, rolling friction is smaller than the sliding friction, because from this experiment we know that, or we understand that, the rolling friction is much less than the sliding friction. When the pencil roll, the book moves. Why is friction considered a necessary evil? Let us understand by the advantage of friction. Friction is wasteful. We know that it is a wasteful. It causes loss of energy and causes wear and tear of the machines. But on the other hand, our normal daily life would not be possible if there were no friction. Nails and screws hold the wooden boards wall together due to the friction. We are able to walk on the road due to the friction, because the ground or road and the sole of our shoes have friction, which makes us walk or run. The friction between the road and the surface of the tire permits safe driving. If there were no friction between the tires and the road, it would not be possible to stop the vehicle. We are able to write on a paper because of the friction, because the pen, pencil and a paper. That is why it is very difficult to write on a glaze or waxy paper. We are not able to write on a waxy paper, because when we are going to write on a waxy paper, our pencil slides. So we are not able to write on a smooth surface or a polished surface. The application of brakes to stop a cycle, scooter or a car, etc. is possible only due to the friction between the brake leaning and the rim drum of the wheel. So we can say that the friction is a necessary evil, because we are not able to perform our normal daily life without friction. So friction is very much required to perform our normal life. Now the disadvantages of friction. Friction is considered wasteful because friction between various parts of the machines leads to a loss of energy. Therefore, friction reduces the efficiency of the machine. Friction causes wear and tear of the moving parts. So let us understand some fact about the friction. Pattern or grooves are made on the sole of the shoes to increase friction. This helps person to walk the floor without slipping. When a boat is on the sea, its surface is in contact with water. While when it is on the beach, its surface is in contact with beach sand. There is a more friction between the boat and the beach surface than between the boat and the water. As a result, it is more difficult to pull a boat on a beach than on a sea. Now let us understand way to increase friction. Many times the friction is deliberately increased to meet the requirement of the situation. For example, soles of the shoes and the tires of automobile are made coagulated and rough to increase friction to provide a better grip on the ground road to prevent skidding. Second, the brake pads leaning in automobiles are made rough to increase friction between the leaning and the rim or a drum of the wheel. Third, wrestlers and kabaddi players rub their hand with soil for better and firm grip due to increased friction between their hand and the opponent's body. Now, method of increasing and reducing friction. In real life, there are circumstances where we have to increase the friction and sometimes minimize the friction. Friction can be increased by increasing the roughness of the surface in contact. For example, treading of shoes and tires is done to increase friction. When friction is undesirable, we have to reduce the friction. Friction can be minimized by using lubricants like oil and grease and by using ball bearings between machine parts. Means ball bearing is rolling friction, so it is the minimum. A substance that is introduced between two surfaces in contact to reduce friction is called the lubricants. Lubricants are basically oil. In some high quality machines, graphite is also used as a lubricant. Fluid friction can be minimized by giving suitable shapes to the object moving in a fluid. Basically, that is a streamlined shape which provide to the object to reduce the fluid friction. Fluid friction includes air and water. I think everyone would understand what I taught in this video. If there is a confusion or a doubt in this video, you can ask within a class to clear yourself, and I want you may raise doubts or collect questions regarding the friction, and you can ask within a class to increase the performance in the class. If you make questions of your own and ask within a class, it is good for you.